Hi there, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily, and I do a bunch of tutorials on Salesforce and related software. So if you're interested in that, be sure to hit the subscribe button. Today we're going to be going over how to create a joined report in Salesforce. So we are going to go into reports, but if you don't see reports up here somewhere in your little ribbon at the top, then go ahead and go to the 3x3 and search for reports or sales, and it should pop up. I'm going to go to reports, or you can click that tab and it'll take us there. So let's go ahead and jump into new report. Here we're going to go into report type. So report types, I do have videos on that on my channel, and I'll try and link them down below. Regardless of that, they should be in the playlist that'll also be linked down below. So I'm going to go into opportunities. It's a simple one to explain. Click continue. One thing before we jump into our filters, go ahead and toggle update preview automatically on. It'll have that blue check mark. And what that'll do is, instead of having to save and run every time you make a change, you'll be able to see your changes live. So let's go ahead and go into filters. Currently we have no data, and so we need to fix that with our filters. Filters narrow down what we see. So I'm going to change this from current fiscal quarter to all time and apply. We should see data. From here, I'm going to narrow down our fields. So as you can see, owner role is completely empty. I'm going to exit out of that and scroll sideways. And next step is also empty. You can do it from the caret and get rid of that. So here we have a tabular report. I want to filter this down a little more. I want to see the status of closed one. And this will help us later on. As you can see, now we have far less data. And we have filtered it down. So now to create a joined report, it's essentially two blocks of two different reports that are next to each other. So this could be just opportunities or next to each other, which is what we'll do, or it could be other report types as well. So it could be that you have opportunities block next to an account block. And they'd be two different reports just side by side next to each other like twins. Let's go ahead. We do have to go to this report and click joined report. Again, it says add blocks of the same report type or different report types. Click on that and click apply. All right, now you can see that we have a block here. And we are previewing a limited number of records because we are in the editor. I don't want to go back. Let's click add block. I'm going to have this be opportunities. We could have this be accounts, cases, etc. But to show you kind of the things that I've seen when creating reports in practice, this is how I'd see it in the wild, as one might say. All right, so now we have two different blocks. We can add two different filters. I'm going to scroll to opportunity second block. We do need to change the filters from current fiscal quarter to all time. And I'm going to filter this down to, let's say, opportunity status of just closed. So it could be closed lost. It could be closed won. Actually, I'm going to filter this down to any, apply, and filter it down by stage instead of status. So then we can see closed won next to closed lost. Okay, so as you can see here, opportunities block one, I'm going to rename this to opportunities closed won and hit enter, that'll save. And then scroll sideways to the block two, and there are currently no closed lost. So I'm going to have this be opportunities closed lost. and hit enter. All right, so this is how generally I would see a joined report with the two different blocks together. You can add more blocks, you can subtract blocks. Other things that you might see is you might see a grouping on a block. So we could group this by account name. So it is grouping both of the blocks. We could also create columns, but the column groupings would be down by each block. All right, let's go ahead and save and run this. I'm going to have this be a joined report. All right, and hit save. We'll have the report name, add the unique name. It'll have an underscore where there are spaces. And at the end, it'll be appended with a unique identifier. So that way, if there are multiple reports in your system named joined report, Salesforce won't get confused whose is whose. Add a description if you think that is going to be helpful. This report is just going to live for this tutorial. But if this report was going to be going out to the whole company, it would be very helpful to add context and any assumptions that you made in creating the report so that other people can interpret the data the correct way. You'll want to add the folder. This is just what is the out of the box what you're going to see from Salesforce. You can add folders if you need it for your team or for a specific group of people or maybe the whole company, maybe for partners who are not part of your company but work closely with you, that kind of thing. I'm going to have it live in private reports, click save. And as we saw, it was showing limited number of records here. If we were to run it or save and run it, you would be able to see. And this, we do not see that check mark again saying it's a limited number of records. Both the editor and the viewer have limited number of records. The editor is at like 20 or so records, and the viewer that we're on now is at 20,000 records. So if you're going to exceed that, you would need the help of an admin to use a data exporting tool, or maybe even use an outside data reporting tool like Tableau that's used to using large numbers of data and records. Other things that you can do here is you could add a chart to better visualize the data. My favorite is the donut chart. So you can see it down broken down by account name. So we have six opportunities that have been closed. One from the United Oil and Gas Corporation in this test org. So that is how you create a joined report. Thank you so much for joining me. This is a part of a reporting series on my channel. So if you are interested in that, I will have that link down below. Like, subscribe, comment if you need another tutorial. I will add it to the list, and I will catch you guys in the next one.